started. Literally, we covered their very first fight. And we've been at all of these shows except for, I believe, like two or three. So we've been with these promotions for several years. You know, we are just excited to once again be a part of this fantastic production here and promotion company with a few promotions here in Louisville, Kentucky. As you can see, it's nothing but a quality broadcast, quality fights, exciting fights, full of energy, full of excitement. You know, a lot of promotions that I know that we covered here locally, you know, they would have fighters that would be mismatched. You have a guy that's going against 10-0 fighting against a guy who may have had one professional fight. But not here at Freak Promotions. So these fights are very well matched. They are competitive. You know, I know we had two first-round knockouts, but once again, that's just the skill that those fighters possess. But these are all very well-matched fights. And a big up to Joe Shirley and DeRico Murray. They're the owners there of Freak Promotions for, once again, putting on a great night of fighting here at the Brown-Forman Hall in African American Heritage Center. And also tonight, later on tonight, you know, I'm sure if you're watching, you are a great boxing fan. What a night of boxing tonight with Garcia going against Spence on pay-per-view. This is gonna be one of the great welterweight fights to kind of thin out that welterweight division to let us know who is gonna be the next great welterweight. Who's gonna take that mantle that for so many years was held by Manny Pacquiao, Floyd Mayweather, De La Hoya, Felix Trinidad, and others. So this tonight's fight is gonna kind of put us on the road to answering that question. And as you see, the fighters have entered the ring. Yuri Foreman has just now entered the ring here. He's getting ready for his comeback.
It's now time for your main event of the evening here for Feature Promotions event tonight. Once again, I want to thank the African American Heritage Center for putting on this great event, and what a beautiful arena it's been. And let's go ahead and get ready for the main fight of the evening. First, we have fighting out of the blue corner, fighting out of Colorado Springs, Colorado. Give it up for Jeremy Ramos. And fighting out of the red corner, you have the former WBA super welterweight champion, the boxing rabbi, Yuri Foreman.
Right now, the ref are giving the fighters their instructions. Now, Ramos comes with us a record of 11 wins, 9 losses, but all those 11 wins are by knockout. So that tells me a couple of things. One, he has power. Two, he may be a little reckless with his punches. So we'll see what happens.
Yeah, definitely. Ramos is definitely a guy who, you know, has been around the block, and he's clearly has power. But, you know, Yuri is on his way back after suffering some injuries and setbacks, trying to get back on top, the former WBA super welterweight champion.
Yeah, I was speaking with his wife here. We had an interview earlier, and she was telling me that, you know, he fought in Yankee Stadium and tore his ACL and still fought another 2 rounds on one leg. Just amazing.
Yeah, that's unbelievable. I mean, just the, you know, when you talk about the tenacity that it takes to be able to go out there and endure that. I mean, because, you know, when you think about boxing, you know, you're talking about ACL, you know, it's all about your being able to move, you know, forward and backward, side to side extremely quickly. So to do that with that type of knee injury, that just speaks to the toughness that Yuri has. The boxing rabbi. I like that nickname. That's different. He's an actual ordained rabbi, literally.
Interesting.
Yeah, it's interesting.
Yeah, you know, he was born in Russia, move to Israel, become the first Israeli champion there. So, you know, there's a right now this broadcast, I'm sure, is being picked up in Israel, and a lot of folks there right now watching him fight, you know, watching this comeback.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, so, you know, there's definitely some excitement about that. You know, he's just a guy who has been around, has fought the best of the best. I mean, we talk about being in the ring with Miguel Cotto. You know, doesn't get any better than that. So Yuri's definitely seen the best in boxing. So, you know, best of luck to him, and hopefully future promotions will be the next step on his way back to the top.
And you see, you know, in this first round here, they're kind of filling themselves out. Now, to this fight, of course, you have to give the edge to Yuri because he is the most experienced fighter here. Now, he's fought at the top of the welterweight division here in boxing. So, you have to kind of give him the edge in this fight here. Yeah. Ramos has, so we have the power. He has 11 wins.
Absolutely.
By knockout.
Absolutely. I mean, so, you know, it's going to definitely be that, and Yuri's doing the right thing. He's working behind the jab. He looks like, you know, a very seasoned fighter, and he's doing all the right things, staying away from the power alley, you know, sticking and moving. That's what they always talk about. Get in there, take your shot, and then get off the line.
As you can see, as the round kind of goes on here, the fighters are beginning to find their range. They're beginning to find that spot where they feel comfortable in letting their hands go.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, and this is what we talk about as far as, you know, feeling out the first few rounds. You know, this fight tonight is scheduled for 8. It's an 8-round fight. So you definitely have the opportunity to feel your man out, you know, get a feel for what he's going to do, get a feel for his power, anything you can pick up as far as his plan of attack. So very entertaining round, but a tough round to score. I mean, these early rounds are always interesting to me, Haven, just to see what the judges are looking for. You know, and I'd love to sit down and talk to the venerable one, Carlo Kellum, to ask him, how do you score those early rounds? When, you know, because I think both guys went out there. Neither guy really seemed to be giving way. You know, there was a lot of punches thrown, not much landed. So what are you looking for? You know, what do you see when you look for those early rounds?
You know, in these early rounds, you look to see who establishes themselves. You know, who's going to establish themselves behind the jab, who's landing more of the jabs, especially if they're both still kind of filling each other out. You know, you really want to kind of hone in on whose jab is sticking, which jab is crisper, which jab is actually landing and doing more damage. And usually, you know, these first rounds are about, you know, landing, you know, punch count and landing. You know, who's landed more of their punches?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, and, you know, they always talk about, you know, Emmanuel Stewart always used to talk about ring generalship. You know, who's moving forward versus who's moving backward? Who's the one who's dictating the tempo and the pace? And, you know, it's interesting right now because, you know, if you were to look at it, it seems to me that Ramos seems to be the aggressor, but Yuri, even though he's not necessarily the guy who's coming forward, it seems like he's had the cleaner shot so far.
You know, and this is a pretty risky fight for Yuri to come back on. You know, I know they probably looked at his record and said he has 9 losses, but 11 wins by 11 knockouts. Now, lets you know if Yuri, you know, is a little rusty and gets caught sleeping, he could go to sleep.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this is one of those things where you've got to take care and make sure your defense is up to snuff. So, you know, but Yuri seems to be very locked in. He's measuring his guy. He's using his length. He has a slight length advantage, it seems to be. So with that reach advantage, he's making sure to keep Ramos from getting in tight and really throwing too many of those heavy blows.
Now, earlier this round, Yuri did connect with a nice roundhouse left as he was moving to his left. And really caught him on an angle, got a nice clear shot on the jaw. Didn't have any effect, but there's something to maybe look out for as the fight goes on, if he can maybe create those angles again in order to free up that left hand.
Yeah, absolutely. And that kind of goes back to what we were talking about as far as feeling your opponent out, seeing where the holes are in their defense, or seeing if the guy's overextending himself when he's coming in to throw those shots. When they call it the sweet science, it is literally that. You're looking for small tails with the feet, looking for small tails with the elbows, you know, where guys are either showing when they're going to throw or what they're going to throw, and then how can you take advantage of it and to deliver, you know, the knockout blow.
And you're doing all that while trying not to get hit.
Yeah. Hey, you know, I mean, that's why you know, you don't practice. Ooh,
nice uppercut there by Yuri. Nice left-hand uppercut.
Very crisp.
You know, and this is the type of fight that you expect from two experienced fighters. You know, guys kind of filling each other out, finding which punches are going to land, and starting to land some punches. Slowly start to build up your combinations of punches that you know are going to be effective against your opponent's style there. So very, very well-matched fight so far.
Yeah, and that's one of the things that you see with younger fighters is that a lot of times younger fighters or guys that are early in their career seem to be a little bit more over-aggressive, you know, trying to look to either throw the knockout blow or deliver the big punch. And, you know, when you get to these more seasoned fighters, they definitely tend to take their time, you know, and really measure their guys. And it becomes the small details, because when you're fighting against another very experienced boxer, they're not going to give you a lot of open and available space. So those opportunities are going to be fleeting. So as the fight goes on, either you're going to find something that you can take advantage of, or it could be a situation where the conditioning comes into play. Who has the better conditioning? And does, as your conditioning wane, as you get tired, do you start to slip up, make mistakes, leave your hands down, and then the opposition can take advantage?
It looks like right now Ramos knows he has the power, but he's being very smart. He's trying to set up his power shots. You know, he's not just letting his hands fly. He knows he's in the ring with a former champion, so he's being very measured with how he throws his hands, and he's picking and choosing very carefully when to throw his power punches. Very smart.
Yeah, absolutely. He's looking for his opportunity. He's looking for his chance. I think he's staying aggressive enough to where he's given himself a chance to win these rounds on the judges' scorecards. But he's definitely a guy who I would think is looking for the knockout, considering every win he's had has come by way of knockout.
And you kind of see him right now, you know, he's trying to bait Yuri into letting his hands go, to kind of throw his hands so he can counterpunch and, you know, and showcase his power.
Yeah, absolutely. But I think Yuri is very measured with his attack right now. He's taking advantage, and he's not getting robotic with it. He's trying to keep Ramos off balance and not letting him know when he's going to throw the combinations or where he's going to throw the combinations. And that way, you can't, you know, give your opponent any sort of timing cues or anything to be able to go out there and throw those punches. He's fighting a very smart fight so far.
You know, he's the definition of your cagey veteran.
Yes. He's fighting a very smart fight right now. A very nice right hand, overhand right for Foreman.
See, Ramos, they're kind of teasing with the power with that right hand. A little low, you know, kind of hit him in the elbow, but it's kind of let him know that it's here. You need to respect this.
Yeah, absolutely. And I like the fact that even though Ramos is a power puncher, he's staying busy. He's doubling up the jab. Oh, very nice combination there. Both guys got shots in on that last exchange.
It looks like Yuri may have gotten kind of better of that exchange there with that looks like a left hook kind of caught him kind of flush. You know, you can hear the ring, you know, because there's no fans or nobody screaming. You can really hear the ring kind of shout out instructions to each fighter.
Yuri with another overhand right there. Another overhand right. He's found something over there. He's found a spot to attack. It seems like he's going with that overhand right, right above that left ear of Ramos. He's hit him a couple times right in that same spot.
It's like he's found his range, and he found that sweet spot he's been looking for.
Yeah, because I don't know if he sees that he's dropping that left hand, but he's found something. And now you see Ramos trying to over-accentuate and get that guard up.
Well, you kind of see when Ramos bounces in the ring, when he tends to bounce, he tends to drop his hands on his bounce. And that's when Yuri's hitting him with that overhand right. Right when he bounces and he drops those hands at the same time, here comes that right.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, and that's what you talk about being a technician in the ring. I mean, because it's those small things that make the difference between a win and a loss. And Yuri seems very calculated. This past round, I started to see Yuri start to become more of the aggressive. You know, Ramos seemed to be the guy coming forward the first couple of rounds. But that last round, Yuri definitely seemed to be stepping up the activity level and stepping up the aggressiveness.
Oh, yeah. You know, he spent those first couple of rounds trying to find that spot, and he found it. He found that spot on the bounce.
So
he drops his hand. So now it's up to Ramos to counter. Now he knows he's getting hit. He has to realize he's getting hit when he bounces and he kind of rotates those hands down. So now he's to bounce and keep those hands up.
And that's actually what I was going to ask you. You know, if you're in the blue corner right now of the Ramos team, you know, what are you telling your fighter as far as, you know, coming out for this next round?
And right now he's doing pretty good. And you can see now his hands are up higher.
Yes.
He has his hands up higher. So he's automatically corrected what he was doing. Now it's to see that now he has his hands up higher. Now it's to see if he can maybe find a spot where a weakness in Yuri's defense where he can, you know, start to get some offense going. We kind of let loose with that power and kind of, you know, maybe kind of back Yuri off, but let him feel that power, let him taste it a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, and you got it. You if you're going to you know, be the big hitter or the power puncher, you've got to figure out a way to get in there. I don't know if you want to try to take advantage to see if maybe if Yuri gets close to those corners, you start to be more aggressive, you know, but you're going to have to, you know, start to do that because I see his activity level going backwards more so than going forwards.
And that's kind of hard thing to do. You know, once you know your opponent kind of has the advantage, you know, how do you switch that? Like, how do you swing that advantage in your favor? The only way to do that is that once he's found a hole in your defense, you have to find a hole in his or make one. And as long as you have punching power, you can always make your hole.
Yeah, I mean, that they always say that's the one thing you got is that right hand. You know, the power punchers say that's the one wild card is that I always got this howitzer on my right side ready to blow. But you know what? A very smart technician can make sure that right hand never goes off.
Now, you can tell that Yuri is a cagey veteran with his movements, his sharp movements. He keeps his chin nice and low and tucked, so it's not an easy target.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, he's not going to take any chances unnecessarily. I mean, so if you're Ramos, you may have to step up the activity to kind of start taking some chances so you can get in there and try to land your big power shots.
You know, especially with this being round 4 of 8, I have Yuri ahead on all 4 rounds here. So, you know, now it's going to kind of this is kind of the time where, you know, Ramos has to kind of figure out, like, okay, I need to kind of accelerate my pace a little bit. I'm going to have to let my hands go a little bit, but do it in a careful manner so I don't get hit.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, and you know, Ramos is the clearly the younger fighter. Yuri is 41 years old. Ramos comes in at 33. So, you know, he's the younger fighter. So, I mean, maybe it's a situation where he might be seeing if he can test the legs to see if the conditioning is going to be there over a long fight. But, you know, the longer this goes, I mean, Yuri doesn't seem to show any sort of, you know, he seems to be getting tired. I mean, the way he's fighting a very smart fight. He's fighting with the right amount of aggressiveness, and he's controlled this fight so far.
Oh, most definitely. But, you know, what needs to happen next, I think what Ramos can do next is knowing that he's fighting against an older fighter. You know, he's thinking to himself, he has to think to himself, Yuri doesn't have that long. If he is going to make another run for the belt, he's going to have to do it within probably 3 years,
yes.
4 years. So he probably will need a knockout. So you may be able to kind of goad, if you will, Yuri to get more active with his hands, get him for a knockout, and maybe leave yourself a window open to counterpunch and show off your power.
Yeah,
it's risky, but that may be what has to happen here as we go from the fifth round on later.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely, he's going to have to take some chances because right now he's not going to win on a scorecard. The way things are going right now, you know, as you said, you had four rounds before, and I would probably even give that fifth round to Yuri. But you never know. I mean, that's the one interesting thing about boxing is anytime it goes to the scorecards, anything can happen. So, you know, I mean, Yuri is fighting the right type of fight to win the fight he wants to win. But Ramos, he's a knockout puncher, so he's going to have to start to be the one to take the chances.
And
there we go.
See, there goes Ramos. You know, he caught him with those two left hooks.
Yeah, that's what we're talking about. He's going to have to take some chances to start going forward. That's going to be either the best thing that happens to him, or he's going to leave himself open for a big shot coming back the other way.
You know, with this being a comeback for Yuri, you know, this is almost a, you know, every fight from here on out for Yuri is a must win. And at 41 years old, you can't afford to come back from any losses. Everything is a must win for him.
Yeah, absolutely. There's, you know, the time is now, as they say. So he's definitely can't have any derailments along this comeback. So Yuri is fighting the fight he wants to fight. I think that, you know, his corner is very happy with what they've seen so far. So, you know, so far so good. But, man, all it takes is one shot, especially when you're in there with a big hitter, to change everything.
Wow, what a great exchange there from Yuri and Ramos. Great exchange there. He got the hands moving, hands are flying now. And you can tell the fighters are really kind of found their range now. They really found what they want to do. And now they're letting their hands fly. There's the end of round five there, and the main event coming to you live from Louisville, Kentucky, in the historic African-American Heritage Center, Brown-Forman Great Hall. You know, we're joined right now with one of the co-owners here of Future Promotions, the man behind All or Nothing Boxing Academy. I give you Derico Lights Out Murray.
Hey, how's it going?
Man, there's some people. How about yourself, Rico?
Man, I'm doing good, man. Just enjoying, you know, going to bounce for what it's worth. You know, these times it's kind of rough right now. Trying to get a show off. The team can't have a crowd. And, you know, so we just trying to make it, get the most out of what we can.
And these guys, I mean, this is a phenomenal facility you guys have here. You know, everything's live here on sportscaster.com here, so everybody around the world can tune in to livesportscaster.com and watch the fights and all your other fights as well. So, I mean, you guys have done an excellent job, especially in this time of COVID and uncertainty and not even knowing if you could even have a fight.
Right.
You know, to still be here, because I remember I texted Joe earlier, and it's like, I know you asked us to announce the fight, but you guys are still going to have one, especially after the governor closed everything down.
Right.
But yet, here we are. You guys did it.
Yeah. We didn't know what to expect. You know, I mean, anything could have came up. And I think we did a pretty good job in being compliant to the regulations. You know, hopefully next show they slack off of it a little bit. You know, we don't know. Nothing's for certain right now.
That's right, man. Everything is you know, it's up in the air. But, you know, things are looking good. We have the vaccine that's been approved and been coming out. So hopefully, you know, by the time another future promotion fight rolls around, we can have some fans in the stands.
Man, I sure hope so. Man, this is a nice facility. I would love to see this thing filled up. Oh, man, this is nice. I didn't realize it was that big. I mean, we've been in here. We checked it out. But after putting the ring in there and just looking at how the layout is, oh, man, you can probably get 100 people on the floor with the ring.
Easy.
Yeah, easy.
So, what's next for future promotions here?
Well, we would like to get a show off February, maybe March. Just depends on, you know, regulations. You just don't know what's to come. And like you said, I have an amateur program. I would like to start getting some amateur shows going, maybe even some pro-ams.
Oh, wow.
Yep.
It's been a while since we've had a good pro-am show here in Louisville, Kentucky. It'd be good to see the pros, the amateurs out there, so amateurs can stay and watch and learn a couple of things from the professionals.
Right. And, you know, the amateur program in Louisville is really – it's really stepped up. We've got a lot of talent here in this city. And I think these guys are going to turn pro someday, so we're going to see a whole different face of boxing in probably the next 5 years.
That's just amazing. Talking about talent, you know, getting a guy like Yuri Foreman here on a future promotions card is just huge.
Yeah, I know. I know it's a blessing, to land a fighter like this. Hopefully we can get him back for another one.
It's always great when we can see fighters of this caliber here in our hometown.
Right.
And be so accessible. You know, guys who can come right now to African American Heritage Center if we could have fans. At a very affordable price here, have a great night of fighting, and get to see, you know, some of the future talent.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, for all our listeners out there, and especially those locally, if they want to maybe get their kids in the All or Nothing Box Academy, and I would suggest, you know, boys and girls, doesn't matter, can all come to the All or Nothing Box Academy. Why don't you tell us about, you know, how to get involved?
Well, first of all, you know, find a kid who really wants to do it. You know, be dedicated. Be dedicated to your kids. You know, getting them, you know, just getting them to practice and keeping them encouraged. Because that's one of the things that's needed to get a kid to do a sport like this. This is not a team sport. It takes a lot of preparation to get in there and perform for just 3 rounds. I mean, that's even hard because the pros, I mean, the amateurs, it's very intense. You know, they throw punches in bunches. They just keep coming, where in the pros is more strategic. So, you know, just being supportive of your kids and just keep pushing them. You know, and that's really it. Just keep pushing. You know, if you want to get your kids involved in boxing, we have several good gyms here in Louisville. You want to make sure you get all the you know, get them registered and, you know, get all the medicals and stuff taken care of just to make sure that they can do this sport.
No doubt. So here we are, the 7th round here. We're coming down to the big money rounds. The championship round is coming up next. And what a very competitive fight here we have with Yuri Foreman and Jeremy Ramos.
Oh, yeah, he's in there with a solid opponent. I like how he's just boxing and, you know, just trying to fill him out. I mean, he's not, you know, he's trying to make a comeback. He's looking pretty good. I like what Yuri's doing. I think he should start picking it up a little bit more, though. I mean, we're getting later in the rounds. But I know he's trying to see what he got.
You know, and we're seeing that Jeremy Ramos has really, really picked it up this round. You know, past couple of rounds, he was, you know, kind of waiting and trying to be a counterpuncher, but now it looks like he's being aggressive. He's stalking.
I think he does need to get more aggressive in this round. He's did all the filling out. I mean, what round are we in now?
The 7th round.
The 7th round, yeah. It's really time to put the pedal to it now. But the thing I'm really impressed with, though, is that he's been bouncing around for 7 rounds.
If a guy was 41 years old, that's impressive.
Yeah, that's impressive.
Like I said earlier, though, it's kind of for Yuri, for his first comeback fight, I thought this was a very scary fight for him to pick. I mean, I know that Jim Ramos has 9 losses, but his 11 wins all by knockout. And when you're on your comeback to fight somebody with that much power, that's a very risky fight to take.
Oh yeah, and this guy, he's game. He didn't come in to lay down. He came in to fight. But you can see the skill level starting to separate the fight. You know, as you get later on, you can see where the skill level starting to kick in, and it's really starting to separate.
Because if I was making my comeback at 41, I probably would have fought somebody that maybe had like 3 wins and 55 losses. So I at least look good.
Oh.
Okay, that's rule to slip. But man, what a great exchange there by both fighters. Like, they both got great hits on that exchange. And Jeremy Ramos, he does not look deterred at all. Not one bit.
No, not at all. Very impressed how he's just hanging in there. Yeah, I think this is a good, I know you said it's dangerous, but this is a good comeback just to see what he still got in the tank and to see if he can, you know, just carry on with his comeback.
But it's a good test for it. It's let you know exactly where you are in your comeback. You know, it was all that training for the past 3 years. Yeah. You know, was it worth it?
Right.
You know, have you maybe got maybe a little slot slower than what you, you know, were when you was back in your prime?
Yeah, because you don't know, and it is risky because you don't know where you're at after being out of the ring for a while. But then it also comes down to, you know, the good, you know, the sparring that you get. And a lot of, but also too, the sparring doesn't really, it's not the same as a real fight. The intensity is different. But it is good to, you know, to get some good work in preparation of a fight.
So here we are, the 8th round. This is the championship round.
Yep.
This we're going to find out, you know, what these guys have in their tank right now and have it.
Yeah, this is where, you know, the
have it 6-7 for Yuri so far. 6 rounds out of 7 for Yuri. So I think if Ramos wants to pull out the upset victory, he's going to need a knockout.
Yeah, most definitely. I think he controlled the whole fight. And I think this is the round where, you know, the 8th round, you know, you can see he's a little gassed over there, but it's time to just put the pedal to the metal.
Now, I expect Ramos to come out here upset like somebody stepped on his brand new pair of Jordans.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. He's got a, like you said, I think he's leading the fight decisively.
And this is how you fight an 8th round. You know, you let it all hang out.
Yeah, this last round, you got to go all out, man. Yuri, he's been pacing himself, really. I know he's picked it up a little bit the last 2 rounds, but he has fallen a good pace. He'll throw a flurry here and there, just like he just did there. But he's been keeping a good pace. Good footwork. I'm real impressed with his footwork.
You know, but and from looking at a Yuri fight, you would never think he was 41 years old, because normally after, you know, your mid-30s, that's when you kind of expect to see your skills kind of tail off. Yeah. But he still looks pretty sharp.
Yeah, and then, you know, you expect to see them use more defense, more countering, more of the old man tricks. But, yeah, he still looks still like he got a lot of juice in those legs.
Yeah, he has a lot more juice in his legs than I do at 46, I can tell you that. I would have taken a knee by now. Rolled out the ring and quit.
Oh, man, you know, I do good to give you a couple of rounds. And that's just playing around with the kids at the gym.
Ooh.
Yeah, this guy's tough.
Nice straight right there by Jeremy Ramos. It's like about 1:15 left in this fight. Nice flurry there by Yuri. I expect Ramos to really kind of turn it up from here on now.
Yeah, gonna have to.
This has been a very clean fight, you know, pretty much most of the fight. Not too much grabbing.
Nah, it's been a lot of boxing, a lot of good footwork, moving around. Good ring generalship for really both guys, you know, even, you know, again, coming forward, you know, he's doing what he's trying to do, but Yuri, he's not allowing himself to stay on those ropes and letting him get off.
A little slippage there. Okay, here we go, 10 seconds to go. Okay, here comes that flurry, as we expected. That's a good, smart old man move by Yuri there. As soon as that flurry came out, just grabbed him arms and hold on for 10 seconds.
Yep, make him reset. That was a good fight. I was impressed. So what you got is 7-1 Yuri.
Have a 7-1 Yuri, but we'll see if the judges agree or not.
Yeah.
I thought in the fifth round that Jeremy Ramos did a pretty good job of being the aggressor in that round and kind of changing things around. But I thought Yuri landed the cleaner shots in the fight.
He boxed a good clean fight. Do nice clean crisp punches. You know, to be someone to be out of, you know, to be out of the ring that long and throw some crisp combinations, you know, that's pretty impressive.
Oh yeah, because anytime out of the ring for 3 years, that's a long time.
Right.
That's a super long time to be out of the ring.
Mm-hmm. Right. So we'll just see how they score. I'll let you get back at your partner in crime.
Well, our partner in crime is about to be the ring announcer. She's going to let us know who won the fight. So what a great evening of fighting here, coming to you from the Kentucky Center of African American Heritage in Louisville, Kentucky. We're here at another Future Promotions event, and I tell you, they put together a tremendous card for tonight. I mean, 6 excellent fights with 1 exhibition fight there due to disqualification, but still a great fight in his own right. We got to see a title change hands tonight. The ABF's flyweight title here got to change hands. We got to see a title fight. We got to see a very competitive main event here with Yuri Foreman on his comeback, the former WBC champion. So now he is starting his comeback here at 41 years of age. We're going to see now what the judges thought. Like I said, I thought that this was a very good fight. I gave the fight to Yuri 7-1 over Jeremy Ramos. Ramos, I thought, acquitted himself very, very well. You know, especially his last couple of rounds, you know, he really tried to be the aggressor. He really tried to push the pace there. But I thought that Yuri there was just being a better ring tactician. You can really see that his experience from being in championship fights, fighting the best like Miguel Cotto, you kind of see that come through there, you know, towards the end.
Yeah, we're just waiting on the decision right now, Haven. I'm getting nervous. It's the first time I'm going to announce the winners on a card in a main event fight. I have butterflies in my stomach. Hoping I don't pull like Steve Harvey and call out the wrong corner.
You better not. I will let you have it from here on out.
Nah, come on now. You know me better than that. So we'll have that decision coming right up next.
We'd like to thank our sponsors here for helping us put on such a great show. Bob Cooks, Locksmith Service, Future Promotions, All or Nothing Boxing Academy, the Main Event Sports Show. And I'd like to thank our host here at the Kentucky Center for African American Heritage here in Louisville, Kentucky, right here on the corner of 18th and Muhammad Ali in downtown Louisville, Kentucky. We also would like to thank our broadcasting partner here with LiveSportsCast.com. LiveSportsCast.com is your home from sports in the Kentucky, Indiana, and Ohio area. Now to our ring announcer.
Once again, before we make the announcement, just want to thank our great sponsors, Bob Cooks, Locksmith Services, Main Event Sports, as well as Live Sportscaster. Judge 1 scores about 77-75, Ramos. Judge 2 scores about 77-75, Foreman. And Judge
Judge 3 scores the bout 77-75 for the winner by split decision. Hit the red corner, the boxing rabbi, Yuri Foreman.
Wow, what a great fight. What a close fight there. As you can tell, you know, I gave it 7-1. It looks like most of the judges saw it my way, but one judge gave it to Ramos. But you know what? I can understand you giving the fight to Ramos there, especially towards the end when he looked like he was the aggressor. But I do believe the judges got this one correct, and the comeback has started for Yuri. The comeback has started.
Close decision. You know, it was. This is what we talk about. Anytime you go to the cards, anything can happen. And one of the judges scored the fight for Ramos. You know, the other two judges scoring for Foreman. But great, great fight. A great way to end it. Just a wonderful evening overall. You know, again, want to give a special shout out to the African American Heritage Center here, the Kentucky Center for African American Heritage, and putting on this great event. And just a great thanks to you know, everybody who helped put this thing together. And you know, doing something like this in the middle of a pandemic, man, is always a tough situation. So, just a great night overall, Haven.
A very great night of boxing here. No, it was a great night, but it was a very energetic night of fight. We got to see two first-round knockouts. We got to see a very competitive fight. We got to see a title change hands.
Yes.
Tonight. So this was six tremendous fights in one exhibition, which is always good to see, you know, the young guys get a little work, let the champion get a little work himself, because, you know, he didn't want to disappoint his fans here by not being in the ring. So a great night had by all, and I'm very excited to see what future promotions can do next.
Yeah, absolutely, man. I'm very excited. The Main Event Sports Show, you know, this is where we got the name from, the Main Event. So, you know, we're always about, you know, the action sports, the boxing, the MMA. And this was a wonderful night of fighting. It was great for us to be able to link back up with future promotions to do this. And, you know, as we always do, Haven, things changed and moved and morphed as the night went along. And, you know, we handled it and just great shout out to the folks at Live Sportscaster for putting on an A-plus viewing experience for everybody, as always. And I just want to thank everybody who logged into our great pay-per-view as well. Thank you for that. And good luck to Yuri Foreman on what's next. Like you said, the comeback is on, and he wants to get back on top. So you know what? This is a good start. So we'll see what happens.
This was a very good start. Like I said, you know, him picking this fight, I thought was very you know, it was a very risky fight for him. You know, it's not too often that you would pick a fight that would be this, you know, would be this risky there. But he did it, and I am excited. I'm excited to see what happens next. I'm excited to follow the career here, Yuri Foreman, on his comeback trail, as well as all the other champions here, with Marlon Harrington and the rest, the fighters here that show their skills, that show their talent. I'm excited to see what comes on next here. I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in. I'm Haven Harrington. That's Rashaan Myers. And we are signing out. Thank you.